गुड मॉर्निंग राकेश.
गुड मॉर्निंग विजय.
व्हाट आर यू डूइंग देयर?
आई एम वॉचिंग थ्रू विंडो लुकिंग एट द सन व्हिच इज राइजिंग एवरी डे.
राकेश व्हाट इज दिस? यू आर यूजिंग रॉन्ग फॉर्म्स ऑफ टेंस.
ओह सॉरी ग्रैंडपा, कुड यू प्लीज टेल मी हाउ?
You said sun is rising every day. You should have used it in simple present tense, like the sun rises every day. As it is refers universal truth. Didn't you learn tenses in school?
Yes, Grandpa, I learned, but forgot. Could you please help me in it?
Sure. Well, do you know the main types of tenses?
Yes, of course. Our teacher taught us. They are present tense, past tense, and future tense.
Absolutely correct. Now let me know the types of present tense.
There are four types of present tense: simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. Am I right, DJ?
Yes, you are. But keep in mind that these types are also used in other tenses. For example, we can say simple present tense. As we say simple present tense, simple tense is also used in past tense, like simple past tense, and future tense too, simple future tense.
You mean to say that every major tense has these four sub-tenses?
Yes, you are right. Let us start with present tense.
Okay, then tell me, DJ, how can we define present tense?
The tense which expresses an action that is currently taking place or happening around us is called as present tense.
DJ, how can I understand the tenses without example? Would you please give me an example?
Okay, here is your example. I read newspaper daily. Another example can be, Rakesh is asking me an example.
Oh, I see. You mean to say that we are talking now about tenses is also an example of present tense?
Yes, you are right.
Okay, where do we use simple present tense, DJ?
Yes, I will tell you. But before that, you must remember the structure of simple present tense. And that is subject plus first form of the verb plus object or complement. Now listen carefully the first use of simple present tense. It is used to express general truth and scientific facts.
Give me some examples.
For example, as I told you before, the sun rises from the east. It is a general truth. Another example is the earth revolves around the sun.
May I tell you the example of scientific fact for simple present tense?
Yes, why not? Carry on.
Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Isn't it a scientific fact, DJ?
Absolutely correct. It is. Now listen to the second use of simple present tense carefully. Simple present tense is used to express daily habits or routine. For example, I wake up early in the morning. I go to market daily.
For habits and routine. I understood, DJ. Can I say I go to school at 7 o'clock daily and he play cricket on the ground?
Well, your first example is right, but second needs correction. You must add S or ES to verb while using third person singular in simple present tense. So your sentence must be, he plays cricket, as he is the third person singular.
Well, I didn't get person, DJ. Would you please tell me in detail?
Well, I'm getting bored here. Can we go outside and discuss about it?
Okay, let's go.
Well, listen carefully now. While using sentences, we use subjects. These subjects are categorized in three persons. You can understand it better by personal pronouns. They are I, we, you, you, he, she, it, and they. These personal pronouns are categorized into three persons, like first person, second person, and third person. First person consists of I and we. I is first person singular pronoun, whereas we is the first person plural pronoun. The second person consists of you and you. You is not only used as singular second person, but also plural one. The third person pronouns are he, she, it, and they. Among them, he, she, it are third person pronoun singular, whereas they is third person pronoun plural. Understood now? I hope you understood now.
Yes, I understood now. You mean to say when we are using simple present tense and subject is third person singular, we must use s or es to the verb.
Yes, you are right. Now give me one example.
She goes to parlor every day.
Absolutely correct. Now let us see the next use of simple present tense. Simple present tense is used in proverbs also. For example, charity begins at home. Action speaks louder than words.
Yes, I remember the proverb our teacher daily says. She says, stitching time saves nine. She always tries to encourage the students to show their homework in time. And for that purpose, she uses this proverb.
And do you show your homework daily in time, Rakesh?
Yes, of course I show my homework every day to my teacher in time.
That's fine.
Now tell me the other use.
Yeah, sure. Simple present tense is used to show state of being. In this context, we have to use present form of to be. They are, am, is, and are. For example, I am a man. You are a student, a boy.
May I see an example?
Yes.
Nisha ma'am is my teacher. Does it the example of simple present tense in the context of state of being?
Yes, it is. It shows the state of being of Nisha ma'am, that she is a teacher. Now let us have the another use of simple present tense. Simple present tense is also used to express possession. For example, I have a pen. You have a bicycle.
Possession means ownership. Am I right?
Yes, you are.
So, Rahul has a remote control car. Is it the correct sentence?
It's correct sentence. You nailed it, Rakesh.
Thanks, Grandpa. Now, please tell me the next use of simple present tense.
Simple present tense is used to express fixed program or schedule of future time. For example, the school reopens in June. He goes to Chennai next month. The train arrives at 7 o'clock. Now listen, the examples we have taken are the examples of assertive sentences in simple present tense. Simple present tense is also used in interrogative questions.
DJ, how can we use simple present tense while asking question?
See Rakesh, generally we ask questions by two ways. By starting with verb, that is called as verbal question, or by starting with WH word. If you ask by way of verbal question, you can start by do, does, or present form of to be. For example, do you like cartoon? Does she play guitar? Am I your grandpa? And if you go by WH question, you can ask like, what do you like most? What does she do? Where do you live? Who is your teacher? And so on. So these are all the uses of simple present tense. Are you happy now?
Yes, I am. Thanks, DJ.
will all be happy if you will use them correctly in your conversation.
Trust me, DJ, I will not let you down in this case. But what about the other tenses?
Don't worry, we'll learn them daily. Now I have to go to have my cup of tea.
Yes, let's go. We are getting late. I also want to write all this information in my notebook. And friends, don't forget to join me next time and write all the information in your notebook too. Have a nice time. See you.